In the morphological stages of tooth development, the stages are named according to the shape of the enamel organ. In bud stage, it looks like a flower bud. In cap stage, it looks like a cap. The enamel organ then continues to grow and appears like a bell, hence called the bell stage. The bell stage is further divided into early bell stage and advanced bell stage. The main difference between the two is the absence and presence of mineralization. That is, once enamel and dentine deposition begins, the tooth enters the advanced bell stage. Moreover, root formation is also seen. So in bell stage, morpho differentiation is seen as the shape of the enamel organ changes from cap to bell, and histodifferentiation is seen as the cells of the enamel organ continue to show differentiation or specialization. Let us first see the early bell stage. In the bell stage, the crown shape of tooth is determined. The concave surface or the inner enamel epithelium of the enamel organ takes the shape of the crown of the tooth to be formed. In bud stage, two types of cells are seen in the enamel organ. Then with histodifferentiation in cap stage, three types of cells are seen, which increases to four types of cells in the bell stage. A single layer of cells lining the convex surface of the cap forms the outer enamel epithelium, which are cuboidal in shape. A single layer of cells lining the concave surface forms the inner enamel epithelium, which are tall columnar in shape. These cells later differentiate into ameloblasts and deposit enamel. The cells in the center form the stellate reticulum or enamel pulp, which are star-shaped. These cells are star-shaped because of the glycosaminoglycans released by the cells, which attract water into the extracellular space. This water, by applying pressure, changes the polygonal-shaped cells to star shape. Its function is to act as a shock absorber to protect the inner enamel epithelium from any mechanical trauma. A layer of cells forms in between the inner enamel epithelium and stellate reticulum called the stratum intermedium, literally meaning the layer in between. The cells are squamous in shape. These cells are rich in alkaline phosphatase, show high metabolic activity, and are essential for enamel formation. The junction of outer enamel epithelium and inner enamel epithelium is known as the cervical loop. It is an area of intense mitotic activity as the size of the enamel organ rapidly increases in this direction. Also, from here, a double cell layered extension develops in the advanced bell stage called the Hertwig's epithelial root sheath. In the bell stage, the dental lamina, which attaches the enamel organ to the oral ectoderm, starts undergoing degeneration, though some epithelial remnants may remain, which are known as cell rests of cerae. A basement membrane separates the enamel organ from the ectomesenchyme. This basement membrane is called membrane preformativa just prior to dentine formation. This was about the epithelial part. Now coming to the surrounding ectomesenchyme, the condensed ectomesenchyme just within the epithelial concavity is the dental papilla. Few fine collagen fibers are seen in the extracellular space. Dental papilla later forms dentine and pulp. A zone of connective tissue with no cells called the acellular zone separates the inner enamel epithelium from dental papilla. The condensed ectomesenchyme surrounding the dental papilla and enamel organ is the dental sac. Dental sac shows numerous collagen fibers in the extracellular space. Dental sac later forms cementum, periodontal ligament, and alveolar bone. Now coming to the advanced bell stage. By the end of early bell stage, the cells of the inner enamel epithelium differentiate into ameloblasts. They are tall columnar and are 40 microns high and 4 microns wide. The nucleus shifts away from the dental papilla towards the stellate reticulum. This is called as reversal of polarity. The differentiation of inner enamel epithelium into ameloblast does not take place in the whole epithelium at once, but starts at the cuspal tips or incisal tips and then proceeds cervically. Once inner enamel epithelium differentiates into ameloblasts, they send a signal to the dental papilla. The ectomesenchymal cells, on receiving this signal, differentiate into tall columnar odontoblasts, the dentine-forming cells. Odontoblasts eliminate the acellular zone. They start depositing dentine first. only after the deposition of first layer of dentine, enamel deposition is initiated by ameloblasts. So we see that ameloblasts differentiate first, then they induce differentiation of odontoblasts. But the odontoblasts deposit dentine first. This dentine that induces ameloblasts to deposit enamel. This whole process of cells inducing each other to deposit enamel and dentine is sometimes also called as the reciprocal induction. Now, till the early Bell stage, inner enamel epithelium was getting its nutrition from the dental papilla. But in advanced Bell stage, as enamel and dentine deposition begins, the nutrition for ameloblasts stop as the nutrients are not able to cross the mineralized wall. The ameloblasts then look for other options for nutrition. The best one is from the dental sac near outer enamel epithelium. But the distance between ameloblasts and dental sac is too much for the nutrients to cross. So, the stellate reticulum undergoes gradual degeneration to reduce this distance so that the nutrients can reach the ameloblasts. That is why we see the collapse of stellate reticulum in advanced Bell stage. The cells of outer enamel epithelium become low columnar in shape, however stratum intermedium appears same formed of squamous cells. Once enamel and dentine formation reaches the cervical loop or the future cemento-enamel junction, the Hertwig's epithelial root sheath develops to initiate root formation.